kid.
It's a wild elk of Boxley.
There's one with a spike on his head.
Here we got a spiker.
Oh, he's got two. Kind of retarded, but.
That's a good sign. When the elk are greeting you for the float trip, that's good news. All right, we're taking off from Ponca. It's the 18th of March. Yeah, March 18th. We got Bob in the canoe, 15-foot Old Town camper, Royal X. We got my boat, of course, the Spire. We got Matt rolling in the Dagger Katana. So we got a little mix. We got canoes, we got kayaks, we got beer, we got gear. We're going to Woolum, 2 nights, 3 days. All the vehicle dropping is done. It's kind of misty. We're gonna beat the crowd because all these folks here are from the rental place. And they'll be putting in shortly. And if you can see back there, some cars are already parking. Fog is lifting. It's probably in the 60s. It's real nice and warm. But we're all suited up. We're gonna rock this out. It's gonna be super duper fun. Did somebody say blackberry brandy on the Buffalo River? Must be that guy. This is where yak packing trips get adult. Break out the blackberry brandy. That's awesome. Got the boats loaded on the Buffalo. Bob's ahead of us. He's out of sight already. Gorgeous day. Totally awesome. Blackberry brandy time on the Buffalo River. Matt's getting into his stuff there. Pretty awesome. Pretty good times. Is it fun?
It's fun. It's awesome.
It's fun and awesome.
It's better than work.
It's way better than work. All right. We'll catch up with you on the water. right up there where that tree's down is where you cross the river right there and go back into Hemden Falls, which we're not doing it today. But anyhow, that's how you get there. I don't know if you can see, but there's a blaze, white blaze on the tree. Two or three of them, a little sign. It's about a mile hike, I think, maybe a half mile back there, but it's real cool. But we're gonna continue on. Gotta go catch Bob. He's flying. He's a man possessed. But here we go, out into the stuff.
Yeehaw!
Coming up on Kyle's Landing now, however many miles that is. I don't even think it's noon yet. We're cruising right along. Gorgeous day, sun's out, it's warming up. Still can't catch Bob, he's flying. We're trying though, but we can't get him. But yeah, Kyle's Landing, gonna just blow on through this. Continue on. Great day for paddling though, man, it's nice. Hey, turtle. Turtle.
Turtle.
Alright, we're cruising by Ozark. Almost to Pruitt. Making a really good time. Just kind of cruising along. Beautiful day. I think everybody's ready to set up camp and start eating. Put our feet up. Ready to get out of this dry suit. It's getting warm. But anyhow, float on. And here we are coming up on Pruitt. So we're making good time. Just cruising along. Made it to the bridge. We're gonna go a little bit past here and then find a good place to camp. Set up shop for the night. Great day to paddle though. Made it like 24 miles with relatively no work. All right, Saturday morning, Sunday morning. Waking up, day two, no dew. Everybody's stuff was dry, Matt's breaking down up there. Bob's already pretty much down, got the fire going. In our little green pasture we stayed in last night, pretty awesome. Waiting for the sun to come up, break everything down, load everything up, and then head that direction. To the next site.
Filming.
Everybody's catching up. Put this canoe here. He was passing me. That was an aggressive pass. Here we go.
A couple beers. Oh, there's a sign up.
All right, here we are passing Hasty. I don't even know what time it is. 10:41 in the morning. Cruising by Hasty. Coming up on the bridge. Still cloudy, as you can see. And cruising along. Peaceful floating.
I was just surprised like there wasn't no foggy, you know, from trees blowing in and then it's moving down the river. But everything's pretty much stayed up on shore. Look, it even broke the top off of the river.
Downstream. All right, night number two. We made it to just past the NARS. And we're just a few miles from Woolum. Found a good little gravel bar in the shade. Set up for the night, got the fire going. Getting ready to cook some steaks and vegetables. And we're just gonna chow down and relax tonight, as we don't have very far to go tomorrow. We did another 24 miles today, 26 yesterday. That's Bob's tent. You know, it's... Bob says we only got like a mile point seven left, so we could have killed it in 2 days for sure, but we're here, we're goofing off, we're getting ready to eat, and I think everybody's a little tired. We put in a lot of miles, and we're all spent, but now we're just going to relax. We didn't lose anything. That's always good. Matt's hammock set up over there. And I got my tent set up over here. Trying the meteor light. It's good. It's a lot more room than my other one, man. I will say that. And the boat by it. We got some cool cave up here. Don't know how to get there. But the NARS were neat. Scenery's great. Weather's great. A little shot of the setting sun back there. And I'm gonna sit down because I'm tired. Catch up in a bit. All right, we got dinner started. Got some steaks going on the grill. A couple of ribeyes, look at that. Wham, bam. Over here to Kitchen Central, we got the dual jet boil going. In that bag that Bob is so carefully stirring around is potatoes and vegetables and cheese, I think. And we're gonna heat that up, broccoli and stuff. And we're gonna open that bag up, throw it on some paper plates, dig into those steaks. And under this lid, under door number two, garlic bread. About to be cheesed. Will be cheesed. But yeah, this is pretty slick. Get ready to chow down. Everybody's sitting.
$150 a ticket.
This all can be yours for $150 a ticket.
It'd be a hell of a deal, actually.
Weather permitting, water allowing. What was that?
He's talking shit.
We're going to Skull Bluff, I guess, and hang out. We're only like a mile or something from the takeout. It's about 11 o'clock. It is getting warm. It's supposed to be like in the mid-80s today. So we're going to go ahead and scoot. But we had an awesome time, awesome trip. Weather was great. Great trip. Just so much fun. And just so much fun. Can't wait to come back with a little more water. Those headwaters from Ponca to about Irby is just a ripping good time. At probably about 4 feet, so it'd be just great. Bluff. Pretty cool. It's super duper windy right now. That's pretty awesome though. We were just around the corner, literally like been in the water about a minute. We camped right up there on that beach. We made it to Woolum, 51 miles Buffalo River. Could have knocked it out in 2 days at the water level the way they were. Got Bob's canoe up. They're going to go get Matt's truck. He's going to come back and pick me up. And bummer is his truck's at Ponca. We're at Woolum. So I got a long time to get intimate with the Woolum put in here.